Hi, so tonight's homework is going to be multiplying whole numbers by decimals. So let's take a look at the first model. On here it says 3/10 times 5/100. And so again, I am going to put a multiplication sign here, so that kind of builds my array, right? And here I'm going to have my whole numbers. I'm going to start my whole numbers coming down, and then this is going to be my decimals. So I'm having 5/100, and so I'm going to represent that by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And so I'm going to need to come down to 3 times for, because this is my, I'm going to do this here. And you know what I'm going to do so that it can help you, because we had 2 classes today, and I really want to make sure that you completely understand. So, and then I'm going to circle this part right here for my 3. I was looking for another color highlighter. And then, so it's coming down 3, so that's 1/5, 2/5, 3/5. And so this right here represents my 3. So this is 5/100. There I go again. I did that all day. And 5/100. And I have 1, 2, 3. So I have 3/500. And so that's going to be equivalent to, and I'm going to kind of outline this part right here. Let me get a, use my black Sharpie so that you can see the outline of it. And that's what it looks like. So what is 3 times 500? Yep, I have 1,500, absolutely. Somebody recognizes this pen. It was left on my desk, so I want to thank you very much. It's a nice-looking pen. Okay, next one, so I'm moving over here. Yes, you can do the 0 before. It just shows 0 holes and then 1,500, or just the 1,500. You'll see it either way. Now, I'm looking over here. I'm going to put my multiplication because it's building as an array. I'm going to come down 5 holes, and then I'm going over 2/10. So again, I'm going to highlight, 2/100. I did it again, didn't I? It's 2/100. So this is 1/100, 2/100. So that's 1 of, and remember that your multiplication is of. So this is saying 5 groups of 2/100. Because this is 1 group here, 2 groups here, and 3 groups here. And this is going to be 1 group. You're right. I'm going to do 2 groups, 3 groups, 4 groups, and 5 groups. And now I have 5 groups of 2/100. Okay. And so, again, this is my 2/100, 2/100, 2/100, 2/100, 2/100, and it's 1 group, 2 groups, 3 groups, 4 groups, 5 groups. So I have 5 groups of 2/100, which is my equation, 5 times 2/100, and that's going to equal to what? I have 2, 4, 6, 8. Then you're saying 10/100, which is also equivalent to 1/10. So if I moved this over to here, this over to here, this over to here, and this over to here, that gives me 1 whole, 1/10, 1 full 10. And I'm looking for another highlighter. There we go. So I'm going to move this part here, and I'm going to move this one here, and I'll show arrows. And I'm going to move this one here, and then this one here. So if I moved all of these over, this part goes here, this part goes here, this part goes from here to here, and this one goes here to here. Do I still represent 1/10 or 10/100? 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 10/100, which is also equivalent to 1/10. Okay? All right, now let's take a look at the next one. I have 5 × 5/100. Go ahead and work that one out and then see if we end up with the same. Again, I put my multiplication sign there to show that I'm building an array. And so this is using an array model or a pictorial model. Again, I'm going to have 8 groups of 5/100. And so my first group of 5/100, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's one group, two groups, three groups, four groups, five groups, six groups, seven groups, eight groups, and that's it. I wanted to keep going just like today. And so now, this is my 5/100, and I have my 8 groups. So what is 8 groups of 5/100? Because it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And you said it was 40/100, or it could be 4/10. And so to showing that, I'm going to move this 4 here. So I'll cross that one out, move that one up there. So I'll cross that out just so you can see it. I'm going to move this one here. I'm going to move this one here. Cross this one out. And I'm going to move this one right here, and I'm going to cross that out. And how many groups of tenths do I have? That's 1, 2, 3, 4 groups of tenths. So you can do it the first way that I have and then just leave it alone, or you can group it, regroup it and look at it that way. All I'm wanting you to see is that 40/100 is also equivalent to 4/10. All right, now let's move over to this next one. And we have 7 × 5/100. Again, I'm going to place my multiplication sign here. I have 7 groups of 5/100. So here I have... It's 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. Okay? And now that is one group of 500. I need to do two groups, three groups, four groups. See that? And I have five groups. Got to keep going. Six. And here is 7 groups. So this is what 7 groups of 5/100 looks like. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So that's 7 times this is 5/100, and that equals, that's right, 3,500. Very good. I'm going to go ahead and outline this one here so that you're able to see it. Kind of went out a little bit more. This is what the original was, and then we moved them over. That was the original there, and then we moved it over so that we can see that it's also equivalent to 4/10. Oh my gosh, y'all are like, 12? Where did I get 12? Oh, but do we need to panic? No, we're going to do the same thing. So, but this time we're using 2 grids. Worked out beautifully, didn't it? Or now, how many groups of, or do we need to have two grids? Let's look at this. You have 12 times 4 hundredths. Okay? So let me move over here. Again, multiplication sign for this part. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4. I need 12 of those. So this is here. That's 2. That's 3. That's 4. That's 5. That's 6. That's 7. That's 8. That's 9. And that's 10. And do I still have room on my grid? I do, and I can show it here. So I'm going to, this is, one group, okay, so I can continue, because I'm needing 12 groups of 4 hundredths, and I can make another group, 1, 2, 3, 4 hundredths, but this is 10, 11, 12, so now I have 12 total groups. You can still keep it on this one because it's not a whole, is it? So here I have 12 total. I have 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And 11, 12. 10 at 4 hundredths. And then I have 2 at 4 hundredths, and so I know that 10 times 4 hundredths equals 4 tenths, and 2 times 4 hundredths equals 8, do I have white out? Because did everybody catch my mistake? Yay, good. I'm glad you did. I'm looking for my whiteout. Let me see who. What did I do with it? I don't see it in my desk. Oh, there it is. Okay. All right, so we're looking at. So I have 10. Times, and so do I end up having it? Absolutely, it's still going to be four tenths or four hundredths. And then my two, what is it going to be? Two times my four thousandths. Now look at this one here. Okay, so I didn't quite make that mistake yet. It's only one hundredth, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800. Oops. And then I want to combine these. And remember, if I'm going to be adding, I have to line up my decimals. And so my answer will be 48 hundredths. Is there a different way that you could have done this? Show me a different way and bring that in tomorrow on another way that you could have worked this problem out. And then now you have your questions. Okay, I'm going to put the answer right here, 48 hundredths. Now, tonight's problems are, the questions, how did you use your grid to shade in your decimal value? So I want you to answer that question.